All right, for this brief tutorial, I'm going to show you how to record your voice, get it into Reaper. Couple things you have to do. First, if you haven't already, add a track. You can go up to the track pull-down menu and go Insert New Track, or Command-T or Alt-T. We'll do this, or Control-T, I'm sorry. Then you're going to make sure that your input, that it is an audio track and not a MIDI track. So I have input, and I'm going to talk about something you should set up in the preferences for this. So go to Reaper pull down menu, go to preferences. Basically what I'm going to do, because we're not using an audio interface, if you see a box down here that says allow use of different input output devices, legacy option not recommended, I'll talk more about that later. We're going to select that. Now you want to make sure that your microphone is a fair ways, you know, doesn't have to be too far away from your computer speaker, but far enough away where you're not going to get something called feedback. So I have my microphone maybe 2 feet away from my computer, and it's fine. It's not feeding back. So for your input device, in this case, I'm selecting built-in microphone. And then for your allow different input-output device down here, I'm going to use built-in output. What this will do is basically when we record something, we can play it back instantly and hear it without having to switch back and forth from our input to output devices. So once you've set these up, so I have output device, built-in output, input device, built-in microphone. I'm going to go apply, then go OK. So now this is set up so we can record and hear our playback. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to record enable your track. So if you look up here, it's Reaper calls it record arm and disarm. So now once I've done that, notice that my meters are starting to reflect my voice that I'm speaking into the microphone. And you can record enable it down in the mixing window or in the tracks window. Either place will work. Now, a word about recording levels. If you had an audio interface, you can actually set the input levels on your record. You can't do this if you're just using the computer to record your voice, and it's fine. So you don't want to get too hot a signal in something called distortion. So if I do this, notice that down here I have distorted. And it's in the red, and it's telling me I'm above it, 1.7, I guess it's dB, I'm not sure. Basically what that tells you is you've just recorded distortion. So if you see that after you recorded something, you may want to go back and re-record it. And that's easy to do. Just go Command-Z or Control-Z to undo, and you can redo your recording. So keep an eye on this meter. And to get rid of this warning, just click on it, and it's gone. So you want to get as hot a signal as possible. You don't want to get a very low signal, because input signal, because what happens with that is you're actually recording more noise than signal. There's something called a noise floor, and I'll talk more about that later as well. And basically what that is that you wind up recording more of your ambient sounds around you than your actual voice or whatever it is you're putting into the microphone. We're going to be recording a lot of weird things for this class. So all we want to do right now is, once we've got it armed, I've got a pretty good signal to noise ratio. My voice is recording pretty hot. And we're going to go to the transport bar, and we're going to record a testing. T-E-S-T-I-N-G, testing makes a fool of me, testing. And then hit the space bar to stop. And you're going to go to Save All. So now up here, you'll notice it has your WAV file. It's titled it this. You're going to go to Save All. And now I'm going to unenable or deselect the Record Enable button up here. So now I'm not seeing my voice. And I go to the transport bar, and I can hit Playback and hear my recording.
T-E-S-T-I-N-G, testing makes a fool of me.
And you can hit the Stop button here. And then go back to the beginning and play it.
T-E-S-T-I-N-G.
So I'm going to hit save. Or you can do one of the things. You can go Control-S or Command-S. We'll save it. Or go to File, save project, either one. Then if I collapse this window, you'll notice down in my testing folder here that I now have quite a few things. I'll have more than you did because I checked this out before I made the video. So all your audio files are included in this as well as a backup file. So for this tutorial, just simply record your voice saying anything. And in the next tutorial, I'm going to talk about how to export that voice into a file.